Afternoon students, now we shall discuss about the bobinet's compensator. So to overcome the limitations of a quarter wave plate, a bobinet compensator is used. A bobinet compensator is an improvement over the quarter wave plate and is used to produce analyze the elliptical polarized light of different wavelengths. Now we shall discuss the construction of bobinet's compensator. A bobinet compensator consists of a two small wedge shaped pieces of quartz plate with their hypotenuses in contact to form a small rectangular block as shown figure. So this is the first wedge, this is the second wedge. So this represents the first refracting surface of first wedge. In first wedge, the vertical lines indicate the optic axis. These optic axis parallel to the first refracting surface. In second wedge, so this is the second refracting surface. The horizontal lines represent the optic axis, which are perpendicular to the second refracting surface of the second wedge. So both the optic axis of the wedges are perpendicular to each other. One of the edges fixed while the other can be moved with the help of a micrometer screw. PQ is the light which passes through a bobinet compensator. Now we shall discuss this is the construction of a bobinet compensator. Now we shall discuss the working of a bobinet compensator. So when a light ray, a plane polarized light normally incident on the first refracting edge of the first wedge, so these light ray makes an angle with the optic axis. When the light ray enter into the first wedge, so due to double refraction phenomena, the light can be divided into two components. One is the extraordinary component and another one is the ordinary component. So ordinary component gets refract, the extraordinary component does not get refract, because it does not obey the laws of refraction. It does obey the laws of refraction. The velocity of ordinary component greater than the velocity of extraordinary component. So these two components, when reaches the second wedge, then extraordinary component becomes ordinary, ordinary component becomes extraordinary. Here also ordinary component obey the laws of refraction, extraordinary component does not obey the laws of refraction. So after emerging the second wedge, so these two components are parallel to each other, because the optic axis both the wedges are perpendicular to each other. So that's why those two components exchange their velocities. So hence the two wedges cancel to each other. Others effect, let mu suffix e and mu suffix naught be the refractive indices of quartz for extraordinary and ordinary rays, and t1 t2 be the thickness of the two wedges traveled by a ray, particular ray. Here t1 is the thickness of the first wedge traveled by the ray. Here t2 is the thickness of the second wedge traveled by this ray. So the path difference, now introduce the path difference between these two components, that is delta 1 is equal to mu naught mu suffix e minus mu naught into t1. So here the phase difference delta 1 is equal to 2 pi by lambda into delta 1. So delta 1 means that is mu suffix e minus mu naught into t1. This value substitute here instead of this. So therefore this is the phase difference of first wedge. Now introduce a path difference or phase difference between the two components in the second wedge. So that is a path difference, so delta 2. Now path difference introduced between the two components by the second wedge is delta 2 is equal to mu naught minus mu e into t2. So the phase difference is equal to 2 pi by lambda into delta 2. This is the relation between phase difference and path difference. So this value substitute instead of delta 2. Therefore, delta 2 is equal to 2 pi by lambda into mu suffix naught minus mu suffix e into t2. Therefore, the resultant phase difference of first wedge plus the phase difference of second wedge. So both the values substitute here. Therefore, delta is equal to 2 pi by lambda into mu suffix e minus mu suffix naught into t1 plus 2 pi by lambda into mu naught minus mu suffix e into t2. So therefore here minus take common, so therefore minus 2 pi by lambda mu suffix e minus mu suffix naught into t2. So therefore these two components here, take common, then you will get delta is equal to 2 pi by lambda mu suffix e minus mu suffix naught into t1 minus t2. So this is a so the resultant phase difference 2 pi by lambda into mu suffix e minus mu suffix naught is equal into t1 minus t2. At the center of the compensator, so the t1 is equal to t2, means the ray traveled by distance in the first wedge is equal to the ray traveled by distance in the second wedge. So therefore, the resultant path difference and phase difference is zero. So therefore, this value substitute here, then you will get phase difference zero means then path difference also zero. So in this case, the emergent light from compensator is plane polarized light. So by moving the second wedge related to the first wedge, so t1 minus t2 desired value find at the center of the compensator. So here one wedge is fixed, other wedge is moved with the help of micrometer screw. So then you calculate the distance t1, so t2. So these two values substitute so in this equation, then you will get a path difference or phase difference, a desired value of that. So thus the elliptical polarized light can be obtained with the help of Babinet's compensator. So thank you students. Now we see the answer from starting to ending. Thank you students. Please subscribe my channel. Don't forget. Thank you, students. Subscribe my channel.